it was really hard the first few times hearing these. Like, you know, eventually I got kind of used to it, and it just became kind of a professional thing, you know, working with the mixes and working with the tracks, and I didn't, you know, it didn't freak me out, but at first it was really difficult, you know, to hear them.
Jay's a legend, right? He's worked on almost every record that was in my collection from the time I was, you know, 18 until today. So just to be able to be in the same room as him was amazing.
I love him. I love him. He's so such a humble guy with that much talent.
I first met Chester here at the studio. I remember walking down the hall and hearing this like incredible voice poked my head in, you know, and just listened to it. It was kind of shocking. You know, I kind of had the feeling that things from that moment on were going to be different. Something was going to be different in music, you know, with that voice. Working with these older recordings, I had no idea they existed. And then I started to hear him and hear his voice. And I was blown away that he was so good. Even before he got in Linkin Park, he had written these songs, and I had no idea. Everybody's making songs really short these days.
Yeah.
That's like the new thing, right?
You play the song, 2 minutes, 2 minutes, 30 seconds, whatever. It's like, oh, I wish it was longer.
Pete, dude, is talented beyond belief. He did an amazing job of producing the song Sickness.
We got a lot of good songs, but this is one of my favorites. Just moves me the way he's screaming in this chorus.
Yeah.
Pete approached this differently than the other producers. He came up with this bass line that was just mind-blowing. I would have written that line. It just fit my style so much. And he said, look, I actually watched your old shows and watched your style, and I came up with this bass line from it.
Like when they sent me the files, it had the drums and everything else in it, but it was kind of like, it's what they originally did from the 90s. So it was kind of that era, like that genre, you know, that time. So I tried not to listen to the original too much, just so that I could get in the mindset of doing something different over it. Kind of just like soloed out his voice and like put a bunch of reverb and stuff on it and just try to imagine where it could go.
Calling me, I need more. Can you help me feed my sin? Come and tell me it's calling, 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 calling me.
You know, I mean, the original Grey Daze was very sort of 90s. We're taking everything from then until now and throwing in the whole kitchen sink, so it sounds really like the last, you know, 20 years, really, of music all combined into one. I think this, you know, is some important work, really, you know. And what we're doing is going to bring him to probably a new level and a new understanding about, you know, how great of a artist he was.